Hello, Skit.
I am Hans.
And I am Franz.
And we are here to
pump you up.
Okay, we know you would like this year's video yearbook.
Yeah, because we've already seen it.
It has lots of music.
Yeah, and girls.
Lots of girls who don't like puny, wimpy bodies like little babies.
That's right, Hans. They like big muscles like ours.
So when you're watching your video yearbook, we don't want you to become couch potatoes. That's what we are here to
pump you up. So hear me now and believe me later and play it back on your VCR next week. We know you're going to like this video better than our cousin Arnold.
Yeah, that sissy Jane Fonda.
So we know by the end of this video you will have beautiful bodies like ours.
So live from Classic Images.
And arrive alive. It's your school.
Dillard, host of your video yearbook. One of the most significant changes that you'll notice in your video yearbook after you've had it for a few years is the fashions. And never before has so much emphasis been placed on fashion. Clothes are big business, and millions of dollars are spent each year by top designers like Genera and Guess to market their new fashions. And judging from the way you dress this year, you've paid attention. Right now, I'm in a place where you guys love to hang out, the mall. In this case, Riches and Avenue Z and Code One. Here with me to kick off fashions are...
Clint Austin from North Cobb.
Leanne Eaton from Lassiter.
Tina Slide from Berkmar.
Carrie Fitzgibbon from North Springs.
Gary Steele from Camel.
Okay, guys, tell me, what was the hot fashion at your school? Who wants to go first?
Okay, at my school, they wore lots of bright colors. that just were out of this world.
Okay, how about Berkmar?
Well, Berkmar, they like to be comfortable. They're in name brands, or whatever really felt good to them. A lot of people were in shorts to keep them cool and stylish t-shirts.
Right. Now, how about North Cobb?
A lot of people, like, with pants, they wore Cavariccis and sweatshirts during the winter. IOU, already a legend. Guess jeans, things like that.
Okay. Well, let's slide over to North Springs here.
Well, when I first started going to North Springs, everyone shopped at the same stores. But now I think everyone has their own individual style.
Great. How about Campbell?
Well, at Campbell, this was our first year to be able to wear shorts, and we wore shorts all year round.
You mean even during the winter?
Yeah, we even wore shorts when it snowed.
Well, look, enough talk. Let's strut.
My name is Alyssa Granith, and it's December 15th, and we're here at Dunwoody High School for the annual holiday concert. And when I think of winter, the first thing that comes to my mind has to be snow. What is the first thing that comes to mind when I say winter break?
Skiing.
Okay. And what is your favorite holiday song, and will you hum a bar or two of it, please?
Okay, it's Hark the Herald Angels Sing, and it goes...
What's the first thing that comes to mind when I say winter break?
Parties and fun.
What comes to mind when I say winter break?
Sleep and relaxation.
Sounds good. And what goes through your mind when you're up on stage playing a song?
Making sure we're all in tune, just listening to what my tone sounds like, and making sure I play everything right.
This is Lena Reed, arts reporter here at Dunwoody High School, coming to you from the cafeteria where the hippest moviegoers hang out. We're here to find out what the favorite movies of 1988 were. What was your favorite movie of 1988?
Twins.
Twins, it was a good movie, yeah.
It's a good movie.
Great, thanks. Hi, what was your favorite movie of 1988?
I'd have to say The Naked Gun.
The Naked Gun? Why The Naked Gun?
Because it was very funny, very funny.
Twins.
What was your favorite movie?
Die Hard, if that was 88.
What was your favorite movie of 1988?
School Days.
School Days.
Dirty Rotten Scoundrels.
Platoon, maybe?
Halloween 4.
Yeah.
Halloween 4.
Roger Rabbit.
Nightmare on Elm Street Part 4.
Rain Man, V-E-R-N.
Rain Man.
I don't know.
Fatal Attraction.
Coming to America.
I'm gonna get you sucker.
What's your favorite movie of 1988?
I'm gonna get you sucker.
Hi, what was your favorite movie of 1988?
Child's Play.
Die Hard.
I really don't have one. I can't think of anything. Oh yeah, Big was good. Big. I like
Cocktail. The Seventh Sign.
Hi, I'm Rich Wilson, and this is...
Alyssa Grana.
We're reporting from A-Lunch at Dunwoody High School today, and we're going to go around asking a few people about their favorite commercial and their favorite...
song.
What seems to be your favorite song?
R.E.M. Stand.
R.E.M. Stand, nice song.
Nothing But a Good Time. Poison.
Nothing But a Good Time. I can tell you have some good times. Yeah, Allie?
Comfortably Numb, Pink Floyd.
Bad Out of Hell by Meatloaf.
My favorite song is probably Pink Floyd, Comfortably Numb.
Well, all the Yes songs, actually.
Wild Thing. Look at all these wild women around here. Gently.
Okay, what's your favorite commercial running on television today?
Well, we like Sprite commercials.
Why is that?
Because they're modern. I think that Hypro Glow one about the dog. And why is that?
I don't know. I like the dog.
Okay, and your favorite commercial running on TV?
California Raisins.
My favorite commercial is where the little babies are flying through the air, you know, the diaper commercial. I love that commercial where those little babies are flying through the air. They got little wings. Angel Soft. It's that toilet commercial. It's that toilet tissue.
Self-expression. We have several ways of showing it. What we wear, our hairstyles, how we speak, even our choice of friends express part of our personality. Now, one of the best forms of expression is through art. In this case, music. And what a better way to kick off the art segment than with the winners of Sing Off 89. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Okay, tell me your names and what school you go to.
I'm Jordan Neiman. I go to Pace Academy.
Jetty Rhodes. I go to South Cobb High School.
Reiner Pace. I go to North Springs High School.
I'm Kevin Jackson. I go to North Springs also.
I'm Wes Walker. I go to Pilbrook High School.
Joy Lagan, I go to Pilbrook High School for the Performing Arts.
Pam Russo, I go to South Cobb High School.
Okay, who wants to tell us about Sing Off 89 and what it took to become a winner?
Well, first of all, we had to send in an audition tape. And then after they got the audition tape, 20 people were chosen to come back and try out again.
Out of the 20 semifinalists, 13 finalists were chosen to compete at Perimeter Mall. And at Perimeter Mall, they were judged, and then there were 7 people chosen to cut the soundtrack for the video Yearbook.
Well, after hearing you all sing, I know you must spend a great deal of time perfecting your craft. Does anyone have a memorable story that they'd like to tell our audience?
Well, I have an embarrassing moment, as a matter of fact. I was singing the national anthem at the Atlanta Hawks game, and the words are put up on the screen, or they used to be. And they were a little slow, and I looked up, and I goofed, and I went, and just started singing again. I went back to my seat, and my parents wanted to acknowledge the fact that I was their son.
Oh, okay. Anybody else? No embarrassing moments?
I had an embarrassing moment. I was in a play last year, and talking about preparing, I spent so much time preparing that during the song, I started the song off pretty well. But during the middle of it, I just totally forgot the lines because I had gone over them so many times in my head. So I started humming, and then I just came back in, and everybody's like, God, you did such a good job with that song.
Okay, well, I happen to know that 2 of you were on Star Search. Wes and Joy, you want to tell us about it?
Well, when I was on Star Search, Ed McMahon asked me a question that I was totally unprepared for. He asked me how long I'd been singing. So I remember my mom telling me that the only way she got me potty trained was singing Rocky Top. And that's exactly what I said on national TV, and now everybody teases me about me being potty trained singing Rocky Top. But that's the only way I went to the bathroom.
Me and Joy went together at the same time when we were at Star Search, and we went up there at the same time. And I was on the first show, and she was on the third. They do four shows a weekend. And we had breaks. I mean, you know, they only do the shows at night. So we had a break, and we were, like, walking on the beach and stuff and having a good time. And it was at night, and I went to try to hold her hand, and she wouldn't hold my hand. So I guess that's really embarrassing. I mean, nobody was out there, but it was still embarrassing.
Well, thanks, guys. You certainly made Sing Off 89 a huge success, and I can't wait until Sing Off 90. Okay, another form of expression through art is daytime drama, or better known to you all as soaps. A few months ago, I had the pleasure of speaking with a very popular soap actress, and she agreed to help us kick off this segment. Helping me kick off this segment that is dedicated to the arts is Carmen Thomas. Some of you may know her as Hillary on the popular daytime drama, All My Children. Thanks for taking time from your busy schedule to be here with us.
Oh, it's exciting to be here.
I understand you were only 16 when you were offered the role of Hillary on All My Children. Tell us, how did it all happen?
Well, basically, I had an agent here in Atlanta, and I was going to high school of the performing arts, Northside. And I've always been really involved in theater and musicals and things like that. And there was a chance for me to go on a videotape audition for Ryan's Hope, so they mailed it up to New York. And they didn't think I was right for that part, so they thought I would be right for this part on All My Children. So they flew my mother and I up, since I was only 16, they had to fly her up as well, for a screen test on All My Children. And then I flew back to Atlanta the next day, and I was sitting in school, and they called me to the principal's office, and they said, you got the part. So we had a week to move up to New York.
Well, tell me, how did it affect your life?
Well, a million different ways. I was just really forced to grow up very fast, because I was working professionally with people much older than I, and I was living a lifestyle of, I finished school with a tutor, and my life was just work, and I worked 5 or 6 days a week. It wasn't until, I don't know, maybe 19 or so that I realized that I was, all my friends were going to college and everything, and that I realized that I did grow up very fast.
Mm-hmm. Well, what are you doing right now?
Well, I'm in London. Trying to meet the Queen. Now I am in London, and I am studying. I'm trying to.
Where are you studying?
Further. Well, I'm just taking a lot of classes in Shakespeare and most of the classical theater, and just this is really my education since I never had a chance to finish high school or go to college, and also it's nice to be in a different culture and seeing different things.
Right. Well, now, if you had any advice that you could give someone entering the business, what advice would that be?
Well, probably to make sure they have something to fall back on. It's a crazy, crazy thing to do, and you really have to have a love for acting to do it, because it's such a cutthroat business, really, and 99% of the union is unemployed. You're constantly getting rejected. So you have to be able to bounce back, and you have to really love it to do it. So if you have a passion for it, go for it.
Well, thank you, Carmen, for taking time to be with us.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Now let's take a look at the arts in your school.
High in life worth living, I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving. Then I was young and unafraid, and dreams were made and used and there was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, no wine untasted, but
the tigers come at night with their voices soft as thunder as they tear your hopes apart, as they turn your dream to shame. By my side, she filled my days with endless wonder. She took my childhood in her stride, but she was gone when autumn came. And still I dream she'd come to me, that we would live the years together. But there are dreams that cannot be, and there are storms we cannot weather. From this hell I'm living, so different now from what it seemed. Now life has killed the dream I
today is Miss Erin Brimmer, recipient of a $10,000 scholarship to the Savannah College of Art and Design. Erin, what was your first reaction to receiving this honor?
Well, I really wasn't that surprised because Savannah is still trying to establish itself as an art school of the South, and so they tend to pass out quite a few scholarships. So,
how did you go about applying for the scholarship?
I didn't have to apply for it. They gave it to me as a result of seeing a piece of my artwork in an exhibit in Athens, the symposium exhibition. So,
when did you first become interested in art?
I can't really think of a specific time. It's just sort of developed over time. You know, Mrs. Hale has worked with me ever since the eighth grade, so it's just kind of evolved.
Hi, my name is Sonia McGarity. I'm here at Cultural Arts Night. Guess where? That's right, at DHS. Let's take a peek. Tonight.
Fine.
Y'all just did a great performance out there. What instrument do you play?
A barry saxophone.
How many years have you played it?
About 5 or 6.
So I just heard that y'all's band just went to state. Is that true?
Yes, we're going to the festival on the 25th.
I hope y'all do a good job out there. Thank you. I've heard your band has been getting ready to go to all state. Are you excited?
Yeah, we're really excited about it. We have a festival performance in about 2 weeks, and so this is a really good chance to do a performance of our pieces before we actually go to festival to get judged.
Thank you.
The place to be in the 1950s if you were a couple and going steady was the local soda fountain. Well, it's 1989 and the place to be is the local yogurt shop. Well, we're going to go inside right now and talk to some couples and see just what they like to do on the weekend. Okay, we're here with
Bob Marsh,
Camille Gasaway,
Ann Fitzsimmons,
Heath Malden.
And you guys go to?
Lassiter.
All right. Well, you know, back in the 50s, the place to hang out was like the drive-in or maybe the local soda fountain. Now it's 1989. What do you guys like to do on your weekend?
Picnics in the park are fun.
Picnics in the park, okay.
I prefer dancing.
I like going to the theater and then to a really nice restaurant, like the Sundial.
Oh, that sounds nice.
I like to get together with my friends, play some chess, just do some fun activities, you know, talking and getting to know each other better.
Okay, there's so many fast food restaurants. Where's a favorite hangout?
I like to eat at Jay Hardy's.
Scalini's is my bet.
Oh, okay. Applebee's or BT Shepherd's?
The OK Cafe.
Okay, cafe. Okay, well, you know, all these things cost money. How do you guys get money these days?
Beg, borrow, or steal.
I work at Kroger as a cashier.
Okay, so you've got a job. All right.
I do work at BT Shepherd, so I get like a 50% discount if I eat there.
I once sold clothes at a clothing store, but now I just do some work for these people, yard work and things like that.
Okay, so you all have ways of making some money. You almost have to these days, right? Okay, well, thanks, guys, for taking this time to talk with me, and go back and enjoy your yogurt. Now, let's take a look at the couples at your school. Thanks. It's tough work, but somebody's got to do it.
One, two, three, four.
Come on, baby, say you love me.
Five, six, seven,
ten. Just fun and games.
Live from Dunwoody High School, it's Friday night, and we're here with two members of Jason Gallman and the Rest, band performing in the talent show tonight. Jason, how did you feel about your performance?
I thought we did pretty good.
And Joyner, yourself?
Well, we practiced a lot for this event, and I thought we did pretty good.
Lori, tell us about your performance.
Well, I sang Somewhere from West Side Story, and this isn't my first time performing. I sang the talent show last year also. And
I've heard that you're in chorus. Did that help with the preparation for the talent show?
Yeah, actually it did. Every day in second period I've been singing, and so it's helped a lot.
Why don't you tell us about your performance? Did you feel like you did a real good job?
We felt like we rocked the house. It was beautiful. I loved it.
I heard a lot of fans screaming, so I guess everyone enjoyed you. Best of luck in the future.
Thank you.
We hope to see you next year at Talent Show. How have y'all liked the Talent Show so far?
It's really good. It's great.
It's fine. It's good.
Y'all have any fan favorites that y'all like to get a couple words in for?
Tanitra Evans was really good in singing. Same, no one else.
Jeremy, tell us about the show.
The show's really been good. They've had a lot of good acts, and the rock and roll bands have really been good.
Nothing about you every day now. Was a time when I wasn't sure, but you set my mind at ease. There's no doubt you're in my heart now. The distant ships walk on the horizon.
Sports. You know, there's so many sports in a high school, it's hard to pick a favorite. However, I must say that mine happens to be the game of baseball. Yep, that's right. You know, I can't think of anything more exciting than watching a baseball game on a beautiful spring afternoon. Don't you think so, Brian?
I have to disagree, Angie. I have to say football is the favorite sport. You know, 6 months of training, all that blood, guts, for all the glory. I have to say there's nothing better than on a Friday night to go see a football game. It's just like legalized warfare. What do you think, Stephanie?
Brian. Cheerleading's definitely the best sport. I mean, football's great and all, but we promote all the spirit. We're the ones who get the crowds cheering to help you guys win. We do lots of things. We get to make banners, we practice, we get to cheer in front of all the people and jump around and have fun. We also get to compete. This year we went to the Nationals. It was great. What do you think, Andrew?
No, I'm sorry, Stephanie, you're wrong. The game of basketball is the best sport. You got the fast-paced action, the electricity of the crowd, and this little ball through that hoop. It's the best sport there is. What do you think, Brooke?
No, I'm sorry, Andrew. I'm going to have to disagree with you. Tennis is the sport. It's one-on-one. It's not a team sport, just you and the other guy. Tennis is the game.
Well, here to help me kick off the sports segment is
Brian Barrett from Pebblebrook High School,
Stephanie Cause from Lassiter High School,
Andrew Minns from North Springs High School,
Brooke Mitchell, Lassiter High School.
Okay, well, what's your favorite sport?
Football! You're crazy! It's football! It's gotta be football! No, all y'all do is stand up and jump around.
Baseball.
Jump around. We have all this.
Taxing girl. Highway
Hi, it's Laurie, and I'm here with head boys basketball coach Bob Bringe. And Bob not only is a friend to many of us at Dunwoody High School, but he's also an outstanding basketball coach. Coach Bringe, a lot of us are wondering what key factors have helped the basketball team in the merge between Dunwoody High School and Peachtree High School.
Well, Laurie, the merger has helped in that it has given us three or four excellent basketball players, and that alone is going to enhance our opportunities this year in basketball.
That's really good, because I know a lot of the students at Dunwoody are very excited about this season. And I'd also like to ask you, what do you think are some key elements that make up a winning team?
First of all, Laurie, you've got to have players that understand their roles. If you can have that, then the talent level on the team is not as critical. So that's first and foremost. Secondly, you've got to have players with the kind of talent level that can compete in your particular league. And our league this year is loaded with talent. If you look up and down the rosters of each of the teams that we play, at least two or three of them are going to be major college players one day. So that tells you a little bit about the talent level of the competition that we have to play against. So obviously you've got to be in that ballpark. And so once you combine those elements of a role definition as well as understanding that you've got to have some talented players, then it comes down to coaching this and having them understand the kind of style that you want them to play.
How y'all doing?
Fine.
This is Carol Ann, Paige, and Lauren, and they're our varsity basketball cheerleaders for the 1988 season. And I'd just like to get a statement from you, Paige, and Lauren, and Carol Ann, of how each one of you, tell me what aspects of cheerleading makes this fun for you.
I just really enjoy being with all the people and just having a good time.
Yelling.
Anything else, Paige?
No!
Okay, and now for Lauren.
Watching the guys run up and down the court.
Would you like to name some specific guys?
No.
Are you sure? Would you like for me to name some for you?
No, thanks. That's quite all right.
Okay. And are y'all having fun?
Yeah, I'm having a great time.
It's great.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's good. Well, we just wanted to let y'all know that we support y'all in everything you do and that we love watching y'all out there.
Well, thank you.
I'm here with two of the key players of the girls' varsity basketball team, Ms. Dina Elshishai and Ms. Leslie Patterson. And I'd like to ask y'all now how you think the merge has helped this team.
Well, I think it's given us a lot of spirit, and we've made a lot of new friendships, and we're doing really good.
That's good. And Leslie, how do you feel?
I feel about the same way.
That's really good, Leslie. Now, I'd also like to ask y'all what you think contributes to a winning team. Leslie?
Teamwork and determination and hard work.
That sounds good. Dina?
And team being able to play together.
Aw, that's really nice.
Hi, this is yours truly, Charlie Fiveash, and we're here at the Dunwoody High basketball game where the action on the court is intense and the fans are, as you can see, spirited. This is one truly spirited fan, Rob McFerrin. Rob, what do you think about what's happened so far this evening?
All right!
What more can you say? Let me ask you one more question, Rob, and let me get a truly honest answer out of you. What did you really come tonight to see?
A slam.
You heard it from me. You heard it from Rob, and this is Charlie Fivesh, and back to me. Whew, just barely made it. Charlie Fivesh, yours truly here again with you at the Dunwoody basketball game. We're at halftime. You can see Wildcats up again. We hope it stays that way.
Do you have any advice to some upcoming seniors who will be graduating this year?
I led a pretty straight and boring life in high school, and as we say, I arrived alive. So I think my biggest concern, unfortunately, is the amount of drinking that kids do now. I think it's been accepted too much as a neat thing to do, and it's apparent that it's not, out of all the deaths that we're now experiencing of young kids. So I think for high school seniors, I mean, you know, there's a lot in the future to look forward to, monetarily, life-wise, kids, family, work, everything. Just, you know, don't begin by drinking, because that's just the end. I lost a lot of friends in high school through drinking and driving, so I think just enjoy your senior year and look forward to college.
Hi, I'm Holly Robinson from 21 Jump Street. Say yes to your life, say no to drugs, arrive alive, don't drink and drive.
Hello, Ski.
I am Hans.
And I am Franz.
And we are here to
pump you up.
Okay, this segment is dedicated to the classes. Okay, don't say, you little babies. Without the classes, we would just be masses of muscle. And our brains would be just like jello.
Yeah.
And we talk like little bitty babies.
Yeah, the teachers work hard. While we are working on our beautiful bodies, they are working on our brains. And they are here to pump you up.
Oh, I see Angie pumping up, Franz. Let's go give her some pointers.
Yeah.
Look at the girly man, Franz.
Yeah.
Please, let me show you how to do this.
Hans was merely showing the improper way to lift a weight.
I'm okay. It is all right. I'm fine, okay? Yeah? Okay, I'm fine.
Well, enough of this.
Yeah.
Live from your classroom, it's your school.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you. But I gotta think twice before I give my heart away. Cause I know all the games you play, because I play them too. Oh, but I need some time off from that emotion. Time to fix my heart up off the floor. Cause when that love comes down with our devotion, well, it takes a strong man, baby, but I show them to the door. Cause I gotta have faith, I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. Baby, I know you're asking me to stay. Say please, please, please don't go away. Say I'm giving you the blues. But maybe you meant every word you said. Can't help but think of yesterday and another who'll tie me down to a lover. Poor rules before this river. There comes an ocean before you dump my heart back on the floor. Oh baby, I've reconsidered my foolish notion. When I need someone to hold me, but I yes, I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. Do, 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 do. I just have to wait. Before this river, there comes an ocean. Before you throw my heart back on the floor. Oh baby, I've reconsidered my foolish notion. When I need someone to hold me, but I wait for something more. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith.
At 16, all I could think about was a driver and a car. You know, nothing beats the freedom of cruising around on your own. Takes a lot of pressure off the old family taxi service, too. We ask about your choice for the hottest car, and the answers were as varied as the people we ask. Let's see, Lamborghini, Ferrari, Porsche, Corvette. Now, guys, let's get down to reality, okay? Toyota Celica, Honda Civic, Firebird, Dad's old pickup truck. Well, right now, we're at Barranco Lincoln Mercury taking a look at one of their hottest cars, the Cougar. And boy, is it hot. Now, just remember, before you hit the road, make sure you buckle up. Now, let's go cruising around your parking lot.
Today is the day we honor the clubs here at Dunwoody. Follow me. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Lena.
Here's a list of all the clubs here at Dunwoody High School. As you can see, they must be really busy because we're the only two that showed up. So, on behalf of all the clubs here at Dunwoody High School, there's Arrive Alive, Art Club, Band, Jazz Band, Beta Club, Choral, Close Up, Club International, Debate, Drama, French Club, FBLA, German Club, Industrial Art, Inter Club Council, Kappa, Key Club, Kietz,
Land Club, Literary Club, Computer Team, Math Team, DCT, VICA, National Honor Society, Newspaper, Peer Encouragement, Quill and Scroll. I didn't even know we had half these clubs. Science Club, Science Bowl, Science Olympiad, Spanish Club, Student Council, Yearbook.
Yay, hey, clubs!
Most people can remember where they were when they heard the news that John F. Kennedy had been shot, or when Elvis died, or the space shuttle Challenger exploded. What about other events that are important but don't compel us to remember where we were? Well, this is what we're here to talk about now, events that happened this school year.
On November 8, 1989, people all over the country went to the polls to vote for the 41st President of the United States. President George Bush was inaugurated on January 20, 1989, who defeated Governor Michael Dukakis of Massachusetts. The strike with Eastern has been on since March 4, 1989. The talks of Peter Ueberroth taking over the company have just fell through. On March 24, 1989, there was a massive oil spill in Alaska. The captain of the Exxon vessel was intoxicated and had the third mate operating the ship when it went aground. Exxon is being heavily criticized for its cleanup efforts. 10,000 credit cards have been returned in protest. After many years of decay, the underground Atlanta is finally getting its facelift and will open on June 15th of this year. And now on to sports.
Thank you, Nicole. Hi, I'm Chuck Fiveash from Dunwoody High School. The 1988-89 year had many highlights and lowlights in the world of sports. In the Seoul Olympics, U.S. athletes such as Florence Griffith Joyner, Jackie Joyner Kersee, and Carl Lewis starred on the track, while Greg Louganis and Janet Evans won multiple gold medals in diving and swimming. Also on the track scene was Canada's Ben Johnson, who was credited as being the fastest man in the world after his record in the 100-meter dash. Soon after his run, however, he tested positive for steroids, which has become a major problem in the world of professional athletics. Absent from the Olympics was diver Bruce Kimball, who failed to qualify for the U.S. team. Before the qualifying meet, Kimball was charged with manslaughter as he killed and injured several kids in a drunk driving accident. His participation in the Olympic trials was largely protested and raised a question of morality that had never before been seen in Olympic trials. On a sad note, the NBA is saying goodbye to Kareem Abdul-Jabbar after 20 championship-caliber seasons. Some outstanding individuals and moments: Steffi Graf won the Grand Slam of tennis at age 19. Barry Sanders of Oklahoma State won the Heisman Trophy. The Los Angeles Dodgers beat the Oakland A's in the World Series, and the Michigan Wolverines beat Seton Hall to win the NCAA basketball title. In football, Notre Dame was the collegiate champion, while the San Francisco 49ers beat the Cincinnati Bengals to win the Super Bowl. It was a year of ups and downs, and one that will always be remembered for outstanding achievement. Now, on to entertainment.
Hello, I'm Beth Bachrach, your current events reporter from Campbell High School. The entertainment field has been booming this year with excitement with the latest Elvis sightings and great movie hits. At the Academy Awards, Rain Man won Best Motion Picture, and its star, Dustin Hoffman, won an Oscar for Best Actor. Speaking of movies, some of the top tenors were Cocktail, Major League, and Who Framed Roger Rabbit. With the push of a remote control, millions of viewers can watch their favorite TV shows daily. Shows such as Roseanne, Murphy Brown, and The Wonder Years have caused TV ratings to skyrocket. Unfortunately, there were the chosen few, such as Moonlighting and Mr. Belvedere, that caused TV ratings to plummet. As you start to turn the dial on your radio, an array of songs echo through your speakers. R.E.M.'s album Green sold in the millions worldwide, and their U.S. tour was sold out in a variety of cities. Other popular musicians, such as Debbie Gibson, Paula Abdul, and Tone Loc, were favorites this year. While some prefer to listen to the top 40, there are others who decided to mellow out with songs from the Beatles and from Jimmy Buffett. Besides music and TV, many stars were involved in one thing or another. Among the married couples were Burt Reynolds and Lonnie Anderson, Bruce Willis and Demi Moore, and Don Johnson and Melanie Griffith. Brigitte Nielsen managed to leave behind two former lovers, Sly Stallone and Mark Gatineau, of course, to pursue the single life. Yet there were those events that changed the entertainment world to a point of remorse. The sudden deaths of Lucille Ball and Roy Orbison were a shock to fans worldwide. Despite their deaths, both stars will always be seen in the eyes of viewers and audiences around the world. As you can see, so much has happened in the entertainment field this year. Each and every event will always be remembered, whether it's in the minds of its audiences or through the pages of People magazine. And now for a side story on President Bush.
Hi, I'm Chase Bass from East Cobb Middle School, and I'm here with a short story on George Bush. Since President Bush has only been in office for a little over 100 days, it's kind of hard to gauge the success of his presidency. So here's a little bit about the man himself. Can you imagine calling our president George Herbert Walker Bush Little Pop or Poppy? That's what his family calls him. He was given that nickname by his grandfather when he was a child. Even though he has the very demanding job of being our president, George Bush still finds time for his family. Before he became president, George Bush and his family enjoyed Sunday barbecues or took a leisurely ride on his powerboat, Fidelity, in the waters off Maine. So you can see, aside from having one of the toughest jobs in the nation, George Bush is a regular, ordinary person just like the rest of us. And now let's take a look at some of the images from 1988-89.
Love in your heart.
That time of year again, prom 89, and I couldn't think of a better way to kick off this segment than with the last graduating class of Campbell High School. That's right, next year Campbell High School and Wills High School merges to become Smyrna High School. So it doesn't matter what high school you go to, prom night is one of the most exciting times of the year, and we hope you all have a great time. Well, enough of me, let's party.
Thank you.
Well, that wraps it up, and we hope you all enjoyed it. As you can tell, I'm ready to start my vacation. To the class of 1989, congratulations and good luck to you in the future. To you underclassmen, hey, it's the start of a brand new decade, so I'll see you next year. Bye-bye.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Come on, baby, say you love me.
5, 6, 7.
You got to just give me